In a social experiment unlike anything you've ever seen, we are breaking new ground and literally creating new life.
Fatherhood. That means making babies.
It means raising babies.
Touché.
Meet Christy, a 41-year-old woman who's determined to have a child before it's too late.
Hope you're ready to make a lot of babies with me.
With or without a partner. Lucky for her, we found 15 men who want to skip the dating and go straight to baby making.
Lovers kiss here, not here.
Push that baby out!
Through a series of intense drills.
Fertility test.
I did not see this coming, pun intended.
The competition is getting stiff, so.
This baby is as close to the real thing as you can get.
Burpees.
Sudden fatherhood is terrifying.
Over the top romantic dates.
This is beautiful, right?
Oh my gosh. I think I might be falling in love.
Crazy house drama.
He's pretty pissed right now.
Somebody else got the credit for my initiative.
There's a snitch in the house.
What? You gotta stop talking.
I need to know.
The gloves are off.
All right, ready?
Who knew creating a baby would lead to sexy romance for some?
My pulse was going, my adrenaline was racing.
Sorry.
And devastating heartbreak for others.
I'm not prepared to get my heart broken.
I don't want to die alone.
This will be the hardest breakup of my life.
In just 8 weeks, Christy will have to choose one man who could become the father of her child.
There are no teeth.
I am running out of time.
Okay, ready?
This is about who do I want to raise a family with.
Almost.
I choose you.
I'm Kristen Davis. Welcome to Labor of Love.
Gotta change your life. Gonna change the world.
Hi. Good, how are you?
Doing well. Can I get you?
Can I just get a latte? My name is Christy, I'm 41 years old, I live in Chicago, and I'm currently single. Thank you so much. I have my own business doing health coaching and consulting.
I honestly believe this is gonna be like the best thing for you.
Wow, thanks Katie. I mean, I so appreciate your support, so.
That makes me happy.
I'm fortunate, I have very supportive friends and family, but what's missing, it's, you know, to fall in love and start a family. I was 37 when I got married, but it got so bad that I made the difficult decision to file for divorce 6 months after standing at the altar. I felt like I was never gonna get to have my own family. So all the sacrificing that I did, all the hard work, you know, why did I do it? I did choose the conventional path and it didn't work out. That's when I really got serious about figuring out a way to have a child, even if it was gonna be on my own. I'm definitely a little anxious about my test results.
Yes.
I mean, at 41.
Yes, I think it's very good for your age. And in fact, yeah, we've got reserve in the ovaries.
Good.
Better than your chronological age.
So there's hope.
There's hope.
This house is insane. For as long as I can remember, like, I assumed I would become a mother, but I'm very aware of my age.
And now I know the truth that anything could happen.
I'm really excited to go on this journey, but if I don't meet the right person, I'm really prepared to become a mom on my own. Oh my gosh. There's more. This place is gorgeous. I could definitely make myself at home here.
Hi.
Hi,
I'm Kristen.
Hi, Kristen.
Hi, I came to welcome you, and what better way to welcome you to Georgia than a peach pie?
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Oh my gosh, I'm freaking out. I don't even know if I should say this, but like, Charlotte was my girl.
Aw, you're so sweet. Let's see your new house.
Okay, great. Yes. Oh my gosh. I am in love with it already.
It's so gorgeous.
Yeah, thanks. I'm still freaking out that it's you, so. You just have to put
it's
up with me for a second.
I'm going to be here with you on the whole journey.
Yes.
And I'm so interested in your story.
I, of course, never thought I'd be 41 and single, and I, you know, still want to have a family. I can do that on my own.
Absolutely.
You know, I feel like I can and I'm willing to do that, but I would love to have that experience with someone.
Of course. And I certainly found myself in this predicament as well, because I worked my entire 30s. I just really searched for years to try to figure out the best way for me to be able to become a mother. And for me, the answer was adoption. And I have two beautiful children now, and I really believe that it was meant to be. And in terms of dating, like, has knowing this about yourself made dating really difficult?
Oh my gosh, so hard.
Really?
Either men my age have already ruled me out because they think I'm too old to have kids, or I go out with them and they assume that I don't want a family.
Kind of obsessed me to think about. Yeah. And that's what I hope to break through in this process, is like really being able to talk in a real way.
Yeah, I am so curious to hear about the guys.
Right?
So curious.
Yeah, well, I've set up a Southern soirée where the men are gathering now. Get
your party dress on. Your bride is going to be here soon.
Yeah, I've been asking.
Come!
Oh my God, okay.
I can't wait.
Me too.
We are really hoping that she finds that special person.
It's a concern on my end because I'm not getting any younger to help out with a grandchild.
So we're really looking forward to this.
I'm Marcus, I'm 39 years old, I'm an anesthesiologist. I reached a point in my life where my career is put together and I would love to have kids, but I do want to make sure that I have a partner to do that well with.
Thanks, man. I appreciate it.
I'm Jason, I'm from Huntersville, North Carolina, and I own my own flooring and renovation business.
I definitely want to be married and have kids one day.
That's the most important thing in life.
What's up, man?
What's up, man? I'm Marcus.
I'm Jason.
Nice to meet
you. Very nice to meet you.
Yeah.
So, hey guys.
I'm Matt. I'm a former professional wrestler.
All right.
Wrestling connects me with my dad. When I was 7 years old, my dad asked me if I wanted to see someone fly. And the connection was instant. He passed away unexpectedly. And my dad's my best friend. And that's the kind of father I want to be.
So we're all going to make babies, huh?
At least one of us is.
What's up, man?
How's everyone going?
Hi, my name is Evan.
Good, man.
I am from South Africa. I want to build a family for myself.
There's a bar up there if you want to drink.
Cool, thanks.
Everybody's going to be tanked by the time this whole thing goes on, huh?
I don't believe in that whole philosophy of, you know, I need someone to complete me.
I get an old fashioned.
You know, I come as a complete human being, but I like the idea of meeting somebody that can meet me toe to toe.
Keep going, I'm just going to jump in on the conversation.
No, come on in. Yeah, no, we were just talking about names that we forget. So,
Alan.
Okay. I'm Jason.
I'm almost definitely going to forget them again. So.
Yeah.
Alan is this like South African god. Like, he's like a Gregory Peck, Sylvester Stallone.
Yeah.
And like the Peck is emphasis on this like ripped body.
Thanks, my man.
I'm Trent. I'm a tennis instructor. I've got a huge family. Having three older sisters has made me like the woman whisperer, like a horse whisperer, but I'm like the woman whisperer. But I am the last male brooch.
Fellas. Hello, hello.
So I've been looking to start a family.
Yeah, Trent.
If I don't have a boy, the brooch name dies.
Trent, where are you from?
I'm from Denver, Colorado. Where are y'all from?
North Carolina.
South Africa.
So you speak Afrikaan?
Hey, proud Afrikaans, yeah.
He's gonna use that against us.
No, my double.
Completely.
Gentlemen.
What's up, man?
How are you doing?
I'm Marcus.
Angelo.
Nice to meet you, Angelo.
Nice to meet you, too.
Yeah,
nice
come
to
on
you.
In.
All right, Ange, we're playing the game. What do you do? Where are you from?
From Miami.
Yeah.
Firefighter.
Cool.
Oh, wow.
Appreciate your service. Thank you.
It's pretty crazy.
You know how it is.
No, it's good. It's solid.
My name is Angelo. I grew up in a tough neighborhood, but my father made sure that we put our family first. I hope this girl has the same values that I have as far as being around family and raising children.
Squeeze in here.
Nice, man. You didn't expect a no from that, did you?
No.
Kind of a close group.
We're cool. Yeah.
I'm Philip. I'm a medical technician at Children's Hospital. I love working with kids more than anything in the world. If you think about kids' outlook on life, I mean, that's still my outlook on life. I mean, I'm still surprised every day of something.
I feel like it's just like it's a wedding and it's my groomsmen.
It is going to be in 6 weeks.
Yeah, it's true, man. I'm Tali. I'm 46. I'm old enough now to know youth is wasted on the young. I want to see like that connection when you first see her, you know, like that connection, you know, whether that's there or not. At my age, I can't wait to have children. That's the resolution for this year, to make that happen.
She has to choose between us jabronis.
Yeah, I know, man.
Oh, well, I'm sure she'll do the right thing.
This place is nice.
I'm Keith, I'm 38 years old. I live in Los Angeles, California, and I'm a gym owner.
You always tell us to do that.
Let me, your collar back here is popping, so I'm just gonna
appreciate you. Yeah. Thank you.
It's cool, brother. Recently, I helped my friend co-parent her baby for a year, and it's reinforced the fact that yes, I do want kids.
Listen, you didn't fix my hood. Fix my hood. Collar boy.
How did I become collar boy? What's going on? Yeah. I can be explosive, I can be hot sometimes. But I'm quick to every emotion. The women who like me because I'm intense.
Hey, you brought that on yourself.
That's true. That's true, I did.
Oh. Hey, I'm Marcus.
How you doing?
Gary, nice to meet you. Nice to meet you, Gary. What do you do?
I make baseball bats.
Oh, nice. Out of wood. Well, that's a heck of a process.
I'm Gary, and I own my own company making baseball bats.
I've always been very hands-on. I've mastered many things, and now I'm ready to master being a dad.
Weird business, man. Started it in my garage, and now we're all around the world.
That's so cool.
What's up, man? What do you do for a living?
So I'm in the funeral business. I'm in a funeral home. I'm Walker, and I'm a funeral director. I see people who die surrounded by love and family, and people who die alone. And I 100% have a fear of dying alone. That's probably why I want to have a family.
I'll tell you what, though. I'm the reason why I'm not married. I mean, it's me. It's not any girl's problem. Like, I literally have been the guy who's been on call every night and looking at this phone. But it's horrible to date someone like that.
Yeah.
My name's Kyle. I'm 6'8". I'm a big guy with an even bigger heart.
Very nice to meet you. I'm Jason.
Jason Kyle. Yeah, I know. I got a big hand. Try not to kill it, though. You know, like, I was always focused on that thing, which was sports or travel. I did 5 years in the Air Force. Now I'm realizing.
Look at that.
Well, if I have kids now and they're 20, I'm going to be 60. That changes things. So the clock's ticking.
You used to play basketball or
volleyball?
Volleyball. Yeah. Dude, me too.
Really?
Yeah.
Where'd you play?
I mean, nowhere professional.
Ah, okay.
I built you up, though.
Hey, what's up, guys? I just got invited to the party. How you doing?
Hey.
What's up, Mario? Nice to meet you.
Walker. Nice to meet you. Hey, thanks, man.
I'm Mario, and I own a business in healthcare. And my ideal situation would be to be married with at least two kids. I'm the kid from Queens with big dreams.
Although I think we're gonna have some competition with some of the height here.
So you obviously have the tall alliance going on over there. Like, we'll be like the short blazer alliance right here.
I'm the shortest dude here.
What's up, man?
How you doing?
Budge.
Nice to meet you,
Budge. Nice to meet you as well.
Yeah. Welcome.
Are you saying Bud or Budge?
It's actually Budge, B-U-D-G-E, Budge. Right? Wow. Nice to meet you.
The beverages are upstairs if you like.
My name is Budge. I'm a conservative man with morals, and we're here to hopefully be a father or maybe find the love of our life. So I'd prefer not to have a cocktail.
Seriously, you don't drink?
I do.
And
I do.
If you don't.
No, I do.
I don't want to press you, but if you do,
damn it,
let's drink.
I just had water and watched everyone else have cocktails.
Been married before? I mean, kids?
Yeah, I was married before when I was 24 to 28. But I don't have any kids.
Okay.
Yeah.
You were married.
He did it. He went full
you
marriage.
Went for it.
Like, I knew that wasn't the person for me. She's a great person. She just ain't the person for me. And I knew that.
Marriage is about keeping it going. Keep the fire burning. Keep the home fires burning. Yeah.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Here we go. Hello, everybody.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Welcome, gentlemen. I'm Kristen Davis, and I am your host for this journey. Are you ready to meet the mother-to-be?
Yes.
All right. Meet Christy. Good. Yay.
Hello. I'm nervous too, so we're good.
Christy walks down these steps very gracefully. She's got a huge, beautiful smile. She's obviously amazing. And the whole time I'm thinking to myself, I hope you're ready to make a lot of babies with me.
Oh my gosh. I feel like you guys have been partying without me. It's really not fair.
Do you like some drink for me?
I really do.
What would you like?
A glass of champagne would be great. Thank you.
No, I asked.
My name is Stuart. I'm 40 years old from Los Angeles, California. And I'm a CEO. I really want a wife. I really want to be a father. So I want her to know that I'm there for her. It's just who I am.
Thank you so much. Okay, I'm gonna mingle.
So I saw Stuart's game right off the bat, and I thought, damn it, Trent, this should have been you.
Hi, guys.
Christy, how are you?
Come
join us, please. We're glad to have you.
Absolutely. Welcome to our table.
You are exceeding expectations all around.
Okay.
Yes.
Are you guys comfortable sharing with me what kind of made you decide to say yes to this?
I come from a family with a lot of love, and I've wanted that my whole entire life.
I was like, you gotta like open yourself up one day. And so like, I'm here to take that giant leap.
I've been thinking a lot over the last couple of years, like, how do I really find the girl who I just love? And I just thought, hey, I'm gonna go.
Okay. Hey, everybody. Hello, will you come join me on the porch?
Sure.
You guys were saved by the bell.
Do you need Norm?
I think Walker needs to slow down and find somebody.
I need an aunt. I'm bored.
Oh, all right, you guys. Part of this process is figuring out if you're all fit enough to be fathers. I mean that in the most literal sense possible. Waiters, please come in.
Oh. Oh. Oh.
Oh, oh my God.
That is messed up.
That's crazy.
Y'all are ruthless.
Yeah. Oh my goodness.
Okay, everybody needs to take one, please.
Oh, Lordy. Those are specimen cups. I did not see this coming, no pun intended.
Yep, this makes it real.
Oh man, I need a double sizer.
Okay guys, follow me.
They're not wasting any time.
Cups. We're not here to mess around.
I feel like I'm involved in a scandal right now. Somebody hide my face.
Yo.
Oh my goodness.
Mobile Collection Center.
What have we done?
Look, my name's on the door.
Since there's no way to make this less awkward, I suggest we just get right to the task. What better way to start this journey than to find out if you're capable of creating a child?
Oh,
this is savage right here.
Well, this is awkward, but
this is an absolute necessary step
for anyone who wants to be a father, you know?
I'm not doing this. I'll just sit there.
Like, nah, I ain't doing it.
I mean, send the limo, get my luggage, I'm going home.
Yeah.
If these guys are here to become dads, I need to know that, you know, they're gonna make it possible for me to become a mom.
Fertility tests are greatly impacted by activity levels. Raise your hand if you have done something like this. In the past 5 days.
Yeah, what's today? Shoot.
Right here.
This girl.
That's all right. It's no shame.
You liars.
Okay, good. All right.
Bunch of liars.
And the rest of you liars, raise your hand too.
Right here.
Wow, okay.
I should have just left two hands up. Yeah.
Tally.
Yes.
Your room is first.
Oh, wow.
I know it is a little crazy.
Wish me luck, sweetheart.
Yes, good luck. You. I think you'll be fine.
All right.
You can do it, Tali.
Two words.
Mazel tov. Make it happen.
I'll see you guys on the outside.
I know it's strange. He's coming.
Pretty confident.
He's coming. Okay, he's feeling pretty confident. Okay, very good, very good. Philip and Gary, very good. Thank you.
All right.
My gosh, I mean, so many things are going through my head. I'm like, will I be able to have kids? Because I'm hoping.
Sorry. Marcus. Whoa. And Alan.
That's me.
Okay, ready very to go. Good.
But I don't come back, tell the world my story.
I gotta get in the mood.
Okay, shoo. That's it for now, guys.
Have fun, buddy.
Yeah, this is gonna be great.
So I'm thinking, wow,
is this gonna work today? There's five guys doing the exact same thing next to me. This bus has got a rhythm going to it. I mean, the only thing you can really do is try to get into the rhythm.
Tali! Knocking it out.
Use the hand sanitizer, let's go.
Okay, Kyle. Go get him, Kyle.
You've done this before, man.
Oh, and Matthew.
Let's get it, Matthew.
Let's get a winner. Look, I'm a professional wrestler. My sperm will be able to do backflips off the top rope, body slam 400-pound guys, and entertain millions and millions of people around the world. I got this.
Yeah, Stuart!
There you go. There you go,
Stuart.
Stuart!
You've been a winner for a while, dude.
You know what? It might have taken a while, but that could be a good thing.
Let that marinate. Mm-hmm. Let that marinate.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh my gosh. Yeah, okay.
There you go, Matt. Welcome back.
Don't be bashful.
I love you.
Too soon. Let's go, Budge.
At this point, I'm thinking there's no way in the world. But, okay, she's the reason I'm here. I can't wait to spend one-on-one time with Christy. So this drill is gonna get a little messy.
Hey, I'm giving you that.
Yeah,
that's all I'm giving you.
I didn't see any hand sanitizer, so. Yeah.
He's high-fiving everyone the minute they come out. Yeah, like, I don't want to touch anyone right now.
Nope, hands myself.
Seriously.
Go, son. Hey, think about me. No, don't think about me.
I hope I'm next to you.
Oh, you finished that thing off, huh?
Damn it, everything.
Your sample's gonna have cross eyes in there.
I accept that. We see Jay smooth on the end.
Game time.
You do it. Yeah, let's go. Oh, I always watch my step.
All right, you guys, hang in there. It's gonna be worth it. We are going to have fun, I promise. I will honestly say the fact that all of these guys were willing to do this test in front of me, I'm pretty convinced they're here for the right reason.
Let's go. Are we going inside? Yeah. All right, let's go inside.
But these guys don't pass the test. It's going to be hard for me to move those guys forward.
The competition is stiff out here.
Trent, he is the last of the Mohicans as far as the brooch name on my side, so we'd love to see a little brooch boy come along.
Great.
Great job, guys. But when it comes to talking about this, I am not the most qualified person. I would like to turn it over to an expert. Dr. Kaplan.
Thanks, guys.
Is Christy's fertility guys. Doctor that we brought in from Chicago. Dr. Kaplan, would you do the honors?
I will. When we did the analysis, we looked at four things. We looked at the volume of sperm, the concentration, which is how much is there, the motility, and what we call the morphology, which is the appearance of the sperm. We know that women, as they age, their fertility drops. How many of you here think that men have also a biological clock?
On some level, yeah.
Yeah, they do.
Yeah, on some level,
that's true. They do. Yeah, yeah. That's true. We never thought so, but there is a biological clock in men also.
All kinds of thoughts are going through my head, and I am nervous. 38, I haven't checked into that side of things ever. Shoot, you know, like maybe the journey's over right here. Maybe I'm not.
In the sperm counts, there's a tremendous variation between all of you. There's an extreme of 300 million sperm all the way down to 7 million.
Colleen is gonna hand out your test results.
Wow, thank you.
When it comes to actual baby making, these numbers are important.
96%. I don't have no idea what mine means. What does it mean?
I didn't even look at mine. I don't know. The score doesn't matter.
Oh, man, yeah, I'm over 100 million, baby. I'm fertile. Something to the tune of 173 million active swimmers. Shoot, you know, I'm ready. Let's have some kids, you know?
Okay, so remember, everybody, this was to test your fertility, and the first place award with 317 million active swimmers.
Showing off.
Goes to... Okay, so the first place award with 317 million active swimmers.
Showing off.
Goes to Alan.
Get out of town, really?
Yeah.
My numbers are great.
I gotta say, before the joy even kind of found its place, it was shock. I was, what?
For all 317 million swimmers? This is for them.
Very nice. Nicely done.
Good job. It just means you guys got a lot of buildup.
Maybe I'm a little jealous, but as a doctor, like, it takes a lot to have a kid more than just like your sperm count.
I just want to say thank you so much for today. I think you guys handled this so well, and I just can't wait to get to know you more. So with that, good night.
And you guys, just watch out for the girl next door.
On that note, shall we see where we live?
Yeah. Who is this girl next door?
Gary, hurry up, get married, so we can have some grandkids to love and be just like mom and dad.
Today's been a long day, and I'm really excited to see where we're going to be living. They're two homes. They're both beautiful, and I'm excited to come in and see what it's like.
All right, let's make a line.
You guys want to hand this down? Three or both?
Yeah. Yeah. Everybody here.
I know, right?
Hey, guys. Welcome home.
Hey. Hey, it's the girl next door.
First impressions are important. There's 15 really cool, fun guys here, and you're going to have to be in the forefront.
Christy.
To make a splash. And that's my game plan.
Hey, Christy. I just wanted to say goodnight.
Hi. Good night.
Have a good night. See you tomorrow.
Good night.
Bro. Oh, this is nice.
Oh, wow.
Proper dining room area. Nice. Love it.
Nice. Great. This is a good gym.
Nice.
This is awesome.
Do you guys see this? Look. Fatherhood. That's awesome right there. This reminds us why we're here, man. Yeah. Fatherhood. That means making babies.
Means raising babies.
Yeah. And raising babies, that's right. That's just
but you gotta make it.
Yeah, right.
You know what? Touche, very good.
I'm ready for bed.
Wow. Yeah, I'm done.
Party time.
Game's on.
Is it on tap?
Hell yeah.
Yo.
Get you a little something.
Let's go.
Jason's drunk. His speech is clearly slurred as he keeps drinking. He's saying some obnoxious things.
If you do not sing something, I've got your ass.
What does that mean?
I would imagine that if Christy was a fly on the wall tonight, she wouldn't be happy. Is he really here for the right reasons, you know?
Here. You gonna throw up?
Yeah.
Come on, let's go do it.
No, stop.
Jason is a country boy. That's his truth, and there's gonna be all types here. You know, some guys are gonna drink nothing, and some guys are gonna drink a lot.
Oh, wait a minute, no. I'll take you to the toilet, dude.
Come on.
It's just, I was ready to catch him. If he was gonna fall, I was ready to catch him.
The day that Mario has a child, you will guarantee that he's going to be in that baby's life forever.
Yes, and hopefully it'll be a little boy like you.
You had a rough 2 days, huh?
Yeah. I just don't like not having control of myself, you know?
Hell, I don't know. Maybe I'm not comfortable with who I am.
And coming from a small town, there's a lot of pressure for me.
But I came here to be a father. I've got to turn this thing around.
The end of the day, if that's all that's happened, I can mend that, right?
Yeah, of course. The past is the past, like literally.
When Jason was born, he was real cuddly and he was a little bit of heaven and a little bit of heck. He was then and he still is.
Guys, there's a message on the TV thing. Welcome to the neighborhood. I hope you're enjoying your new home. Now that we all know that you're fit to be fathers, it's time to get to know your new neighbor. There's a barbecue set up for you out back.
Come on, why not?
Check it out.
This way.
Oh, wow.
Hey.
Party time.
It's nice to be outside.
Yeah,
switch!
Nothing but this.
So how about, I mean, Christy's next door, right? It'd be nice if she came over and joined the barbecue. How do we, like,
serenade her?
Serenade her to come over.
Do we all know a song that we can serenade Cindy with to get over here?
Cindy? Who's Cindy?
Sorry.
Alan was calling her Cindy. I mean, nobody wants to be called the wrong name. You're obviously not paying attention. You need to focus.
I know, right?
Alan, you go ahead and serenade Cindy.
You're done.
Hey, Christy.
Christy.
Somebody doesn't know your name.
Party time.
How do we
serenade her?
Serenade her to come over.
Right. Do we all know a song that we can serenade Cindy with to get over here?
Cindy? Who's Cindy?
Sorry.
I mean, I remember her name. What is it? Christine or Cinnamon or Cindy?
Should we serenade Christy to get it over here?
We should.
Yeah.
Let's just yell her name.
Christy! 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 Christy!
Hey! Welcome to the party!
This is such a great group of guys that, you know, I know even this first elimination, it's gonna be hard. And that's why it's so important to use my time wisely and really try to get to know all of these guys tonight.
I mean, I always like to start a party with champagne.
Trent, I think, is getting a drink.
Get one right now.
Christy shows up and she is stunning. So as the guys were swarming around her, I thought I'd sneak on over and get her a little bubbly. I thought if I could get Christy a drink, maybe I could be the first to, work my magic. Christy.
Thank you so much.
That was a good little champagne pop.
That was. Your timing was impeccable.
Speaking of timing, you mind if I stay for a bit?
Sure.
You're welcome, guys.
I'm going to continue that thought.
We will.
Okay.
Trent.
What do you think about these seats right here?
Well, on that note, mind if I steal you for a little bit?
Yeah, come right into my office. So one thing I just wanted to talk to you about a little bit.
Yeah.
Throughout my life, I've always been kind of a carefree, free living kind of guy, right? Which could come off as sometimes a little unserious. But don't let that fool you on my seriousness on having a family. And if I'm gonna do this, it's kind of game time, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I know when I saw you walk down the steps, I thought, oh my gosh, that could be my future mother to my children. So that was just a very exciting thing for me, and I wanted to let you know that.
Thank you, I appreciate that. Well, cheers.
Let's go, Mingo.
Okay, sounds good. I think it's interesting what these guys choose to share with me. And for Trent, he is ready for this part of life, you know, to get serious and to start a family. And that's definitely something that I'm looking for with these guys.
I want you to know, one, I'm here for you. And most importantly, I'm here for the possibility that we have children, which is something I really want.
Right.
And just be open to the possibility.
Right. Wow, Stuart's great. He's the sensitive CEO, and I really like that.
As a physician, like I went part-time recently to, you know, make space for
having a child and starting a family.
I mean,
it's like I'm talking right now, so this is freaking me out a little bit because everything you're saying is like how I feel about myself. With Marcus, I feel like he's totally cute. He's a doctor. And we had a little playful time, you know? So there's a big time crush happening right now. But I still have a lot of guys that I need to talk to.
For as long as I can remember, I've wanted to be a father.
Okay.
I mean, I've always wanted to have kids.
Yeah.
Dating's always been hard for me in LA.
It's been hard for me in South Africa. Period.
Right.
Anywhere.
No, I get it.
Alan, can I interrupt you?
I'll happily give you the
Sorry,
time.
Sorry, brother. Nice to talk to you.
You as well, Alan.
Enjoy, buddy.
Hello.
Hi, Jason. Oh, okay, where did you pull these from?
I wouldn't know where to go.
Is this your rebellious side?
Yeah, that's my wild side.
Okay, so tell me more about yourself.
I own my own flooring company. I've done that for a long time.
My dad was in that line of work. That was, my dad had a flooring company with his brothers.
Really?
Yes. I'm feeling really conflicted because Jason was really drunk at the party yesterday, and he definitely didn't give off the best first impression. But the Jason I'm talking to you tonight, I could see him being father material.
Excuse me, guys.
Yeah.
Can I jump in here?
Oh, absolutely.
Okay. Yeah, until he's 46. He's probably one of the older guys in this group. He might be someone that I try to talk to about why he hasn't started a family at this point. I mean, what's it been like for you?
Yeah, it's been, for us, it's been so overwhelming.
Yeah.
I can only imagine what it's like for you. It's all on you.
How was going through the mobile sperm unit, test results, moving into a house with 14 other guys? I'm assuming you've done none of those things before.
Moving into the house with all these guys was just, it's been crazy. So tell me what you're thinking right now. Like, how's your day going?
I mean, it's good. I'm here with you guys. But I guess I'm like kind of curious just what made you kind of want to be here and where you feel like you're at in your life.
I'm looking for a life partner. But I want to talk about you.
I have questions, of course, but Tali was totally deflecting. He's one of those guys that you can't get a straight answer out of. I'd like to learn more about you.
Okay. Well, first of all, we got a question for you. So have you learned a lot of things just about yourself, just while you've been here?
Right. Yeah. I can't tell if he's just disinterested or if he's hiding something. And either of those scenarios is honestly not okay with me. I'm 41. I know I want to have a baby this year. I just don't have time to figure out who Tali is if he won't let me in.
Well, first of all, we got a question for you. I mean, so have you learned a lot of things just about yourself just while you've been here in the last couple of days?
Yeah.
Hey, Tali, you have a phone call. It's incredibly important. Someone says she's your wife.
I don't know.
I'm really putting myself out there and letting myself be vulnerable with these men. So I need them to be doing the same thing.
I had an opportunity to pursue my dream. I became a professional wrestler.
Does that mean you'd be the cool dad?
100%, but without, I'd be a responsible dad.
Yeah, a little different,
great
right?
Role model.
You know, Matthew, I hate to break up the tea party, but
I'm my friend.
But I gotta
give me love.
It is so much trying to date 15 guys at once.
Look at what's happening here.
I ordered some champagne for you guys.
Thank you so much.
Appreciate you.
I'm trying to remember who's who.
At this age, kids got to be a priority. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
This didn't happen this time in my life, but hopefully it will, you know?
I have one brother. He just had his third boy, and seeing like him and his kids and like that part of life that I'm missing,
yeah.
I think that was something that really changed my motivation to like start a family.
It's tougher than I thought, but I'm dating to fall in love with the guy who could be the father of my children. Hi, how are you?
Good, I'm good.
Sit down,
Could we go inside? I'll show you the house a little bit and I warm up. Yes,
let's do that.
I brought my jacket,
okay.
I never wear.
I really want to have a connection with Philip, but he's so nervous. You know, it's almost like talking to a little boy.
Yeah, I hope you like these. I truly believe these are moon rocks.
That sounds cool.
I bring these because they make me feel comfortable here. I grew up near the ocean.
So I ended up bringing some moon rocks so I could feel a little bit at home.
I just wanted to give them to you.
Thank you so much.
Sure, do you have pockets?
I'll find a way.
Okay. I figured it was just perfect to kind of share that with her.
Do you feel like you're ready to have a family?
I know people love kids, but it makes me, I don't know. I could like be a single dad and I would adopt in a couple years.
I'm a little worried with Philip. I do think he is a little more shy. I'm willing to help this along a little bit, but I'm also looking for a man who is also on the same timeline as me.
Everybody say hi.
And the Lord and the
Lady. Hi guys. I just wanted to say thank you so much for having me over. I'm gonna say goodnight. Right now, my front runners really are the guys who are very clear about what they want and their timeline for getting it. I think Stuart, both nights. Trent stepped up today. I mean, Matt, it's the little things, I think, that really show me how they're gonna be, not only with me, but with future children.
Philip does love kids. I don't feel he's in a rush right now.
He knows what he wants, and I think he's chomping at the bit to have his own.
So it begins.
The very first elimination.
Have a seat, young Philip.
Or, and so it ends, I should say.
This is probably from the app that she has.
Yeah.
And while we're waiting, guys, it's been a pleasure getting to know everybody.
Seriously.
Yes, sir.
It's about to get weird.
Okay, are you ready for your first elimination?
I'm so excited to hear everything out.
Let's start with Trent.
Okay.
Moving a man to let's keep dating means they'll stay for another week.
Oh. She's looking back at the
mobile device. Oh, there we go, she's playing.
If you leave a man in the we need to talk box, you'll have the chance to let them know how they impressed you this week or explain the reason you'll be sending them home.
Yeah.
The guys are awaiting your decision. Ready?
Trent was one of my favorites last night.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, we had a good conversation. He's an interesting guy.
Oh.
Thank you. Who's that? Oh, Trenter.
Trent.
You're a keeper, baby.
Your move.
What?
Oh. Kyle. I really like Kyle.
Marcus.
Here you go, Marcus. Doctor. Your pride kicks in a little bit. Like, yo, you're measuring cats up. Like, she's gonna choose him over me?
Well, we know. Alan, Mr. 300, there is no way you're going.
What do you think of Jason?
Jason, I will be the first to say I did not like his behavior at our first meeting.
Yeah, I was a little concerned.
It really concerned me too, so I'm not sure.
Look at those baby blues, man.
Okay, so Angelo, should we go to the profile page?
Yeah.
Oh, she got to look at that man in that suit right there.
He's a firefighter.
Yeah.
Which, that is right. Admirable. He's super passionate about it.
Oh,
my God, we are down to the nitty
gritty. Here we go. It's all flop. Wow.
I mean, this is the first elimination, so it's definitely nerve-wracking, but based on the little time that I have with Christy, I mean, I feel like my heart is here and it is not, definitely not leaving yet.
Are you ready to lock in your decision? Once we do this, there's no changing your mind.
Okay.
Here we go.
Whoa, is this your final decision?
What?
Whoa.
Oh,
my God.
This is just nuts.
Hey guys.
Hello.
While it may feel awful for you guys standing here, it's not necessarily a bad thing. We need to talk could mean Christy wanted a chance to tell you that she appreciates you, or it could mean you're going to go home. If she decides to keep dating, you'll join the other men who are safe for the week downstairs in the fatherhood room.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, they got the good stuff too.
Fatherhood.
Nice.
All right.
Christy, please come in. Sure. Hi, Peter.
I think it's important for me to kind of acknowledge the good and bad face to face. You know, all the guys I'm going to speak with, there's actually a couple guys here that I really wanted to take the time to let them know how special I think they are. And the guys are kind of waiting to see what side they're on.
I'm gonna be back here if you need me, okay? All right, you got this.
I think either Stuart or Tali come back.
I don't think any of them are coming back.
Tali.
Yes. Hi, Christy.
Hi. Last night, we had a great time together, but I had a hard time getting you to open up, and I found you to be evasive. I don't see us starting a family together.
It's unfortunate, of course, that we couldn't communicate a little better, and it was still a phenomenal experience.
Thank you.
Let me give you a hug.
Thanks, Tali. Wish you the best.
You're welcome, sweetheart. The connection just wasn't there. And you can't force that kind of thing. I still want to settle down and have a family. I'm 46 years young, and I'm ready to go.
Well, who do you think's coming back out?
If someone's coming back through that door,
that's interesting. I just think that Philip's personality may be taken as, hey, he's too laid back. When you got Stuart super strong, and Stuart is going to fight like hell to stay.
Stuart, as you know, there's a lot of men here that I need to get to know. You've made me feel seen, appreciated, and like a lady. So I want to say thank you, and I'd like to keep dating.
You.
Please join the other fathers-to-be downstairs.
Thank you. Thank you. Poor Stuart, I really think he thought I was going to eliminate him. I wanted to acknowledge him for really taking care of me. I think he's going to give me a hard time about that, honestly.
Okay, we're going to talk.
Thank you.
Yep, I am safe. I appreciate you for appreciating me.
Up, up, yeah!
He deserves to stay.
Philip, you were one of the guys here that I was most looking forward to getting to know. I think you're so attractive and so positive, but I just don't feel like we're on the same timeline. I don't see us starting a family together.
Man.
I'm sorry.
Appreciate the interactions we had.
Thank you so much.
Jason.
Philip is a tough one for me because he is one of the guys that I'm really attracted to and I want us to click, but I just don't feel like he is ready to start a family in the near future.
I totally respect her decision. I mean, this is the universe saying, Philip, you know, get back home and get to know some other people.
So, Jason.
Yes, ma'am.
I think you're very charming.
Thank you.
I love that you and my dad kind of share the same line of work. Mm-hmm. You know, I thought that was a really neat coincidence.
Yeah.
But, you know, I think I still need to understand your drinking.
Well, I want to apologize to you. I let the nerves get the best of me. I had too much to drink.
Okay.
I mean, that's all it was. Like, I haven't drank since. And I'm really not planning on it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Join those guys downstairs. What do you say?
I will do that.
Okay. I can understand that this situation is really overwhelming, especially to someone like Jason who comes from a small town.
All right, all right. All right.
And I think after talking to Jason at the barbecue, I can see that there's another side to Jason that I think is worth exploring.
I'm sure that's worth a bottle of champagne.
I mean,
Jason was sort of the life of the party when we first got here.
Thanks, buddy.
Yep.
And I'm thinking to myself, uh-oh, here we go again.
Is that moonshine?
Next time on Labor of Love.
It's chilly out here.
Hello.
Hi, guys.
Tonight, you will be spending the night here.
Yeah, right.
No way.
Not only are we dressed completely wrong, but it is freezing.
This right here is VIP at Burning Man.
This is amazing. I just got some information that there's some people that don't want to be here. I heard that you don't even know my name.
There's a snitch in the house.
Oh.
Obviously, she's getting that information from one of you guys.
You know, the game of Clue begins.
That actually gave me such a...
What? What is real?
It's a f***ing... Friend of me.